Archbishop Hannan lived quietly on the North Shore in his later years, a good friend and neighbor in a quiet corner of Covington. But he never stopped tending his flock. His love of life and people kept him out and about, sharing his faith and touching lives. And as WDSU North Shore reporter Heath Allen tells us, he loved doing it over a good cup of coffee.
We just got along like mashed potatoes and gravy.
Few people knew Archbishop Philip Hannan like Kent Bossier. Last 4 years, his caregiver, constant companion, and friend. Almost daily, health and weather permitting, Kent and the Archbishop would visit St. John's Coffee House in downtown Covington for a cup of joe, some cheesecake, and a bit of conversation.
Everywhere he went, people fell in love with him. There was just an essence about his character and just who he was that just couldn't be hidden. It couldn't be hidden.
He was just a gentle person that would share his memories and his life experiences with people and his strong beliefs in his faith.
He would come over here and sit at that little table, and I would sit and talk to him. And I brought my dog in one day, and he blessed my dog. Did the Son of the Cross, Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, and he blessed my dog.
It didn't matter where you were. He knew how to meet people in that place and minister to them.
In a small chapel in his home, Archbishop Hannan said daily mass until he fell ill. Often Kent would sing, just as he did last night and the hours before Hannan's death. They were ministering to one another. Kent sang to him Danny Boy, the Irish lilt, Hannan's favorite song.
He put his arm kind of on my shoulder, you know, because he knew. He knew I was sad. He knew that the end was near. He knew that he was getting ready to be with the Lord. And he wanted to comfort me.
A deep love of God and of people, of life and of humor. This perhaps his last interview last April.
Well, first of all, Archbishop Hannan, you look terrific.
Well, thank you. So do you.
Bossier says Hannan can rest now because he was a fighter until the end.
When Philip Hannan goes through the gates, God will greet him and he'll say, "Well done, my good and faithful servant," because that's what he was. And that's what we need to be.
Bossier says one of Archbishop Hannan's greatest joys toward the end of his life was visiting with Archbishop Gregory Amond. Years ago, Hannan ordained Amond as a priest.